From my sponsor GearBest, I got a remote-controlled model car that I'd like to use for my Robo Spadium. After some modifications, you will be able to drive this car in my robot room through a browser interface. Let's start the video with a closer look at the unmodified car. The dimensions are 380x185x175mm and the weight is 780 grams. All six wheels of the VL Toys model car are driven by motors, the diameter of the rubber wheels is 78mm. The remote control in pistol grip design needs 4 AA batteries that are not included in the package. The drive battery is included and it's a lithium ion type with a nominal voltage of 6.4 volts and a capacity of 320 mAh. That battery is stored in a box at the bottom of the car, the cover is locked with a screw. The screwdriver included in the package doesn't fit perfectly on the screw head, which is why I'm using my own tool. Turn on the remote control and the switch at the bottom of the car to activate the VL Toys. By pulling the trigger, the car moves into forward direction. By pushing, it moves backwards. In principle, you can set two speeds, however you must move the trigger carefully to do so. The steering is not proportional, it's all or nothing. You can hear the steering motor still running, even after the end position is reached. As soon as the motor is turned off, the steering moves back to neutral, driven by springs. You can adjust the neutral position with a tiny plastics lever. When having a look at the mechanics of the steering, you can see that the motor is connected with the gears through a centrifugal clutch. That protects motor as well as gears against mechanical overload. The wheels of each axis are connected through a straight rod, driven by a geared electric motor. All three axes are spring-mounted on the chassis. You can't control the headlights with the remote, they are always turned on. Time for a first test run in the wilderness of Germany. With a 6-wheel drive, the traction on forest floor is really good. The VL Toys can climb on rough terrain. All in all, the off-road capabilities are really good, considering the small scale of the car. A heap of crushed rock is a great adventure playground. It's really fun to drive the six-wheeler in rough terrain. Even if the off-road capabilities are not unlimited, I was often surprised what hills the car could actually climb. With a 320 mAh battery you can drive around for approximately 10 minutes. If you keep the throttle down, you must drive through the charging station sooner. There is no power supply included, you must connect the battery to an USB port using the charging cable. After approximately 1.5 hours, the battery is recharged, which is indicated by a green LED. With that, the fun starts over again. As mentioned at the beginning of the video, my intention was to convert this car into a really long-range remote-controlled vehicle. To do so, my sponsor added a Raspberry Pi 3, camera module, and a double H-bridge to the package. Batteries with a higher capacity and a step-down converter are also needed. I removed the original electronics board and made cuts and drills on the chassis. The cases for the Raspberry Pi and the camera were made with a 3D printer. You can get the schematics and the instruction for software installation on my project pages. There you can find a detailed description of the conversion as well. I'm using a 7.4V lithium polymer battery with a capacity of 2000 mAh. Because of the higher output voltage, I'm reducing the voltage at the drive motors by controlling the H-bridge through pulse width modulation. The Raspberry Pi is connected to the battery through a 5V step-down converter because that single board computer would get destroyed by a higher voltage. The look of the model car is nearly unchanged after the conversion, however it is now accessible through a browser interface. Here, a smartphone is connected directly with the VLAN of the Raspberry Pi in access point mode. However, as soon as the VLAN of the Raspberry Pi gets connected to the internet, you can control the vehicle from any place on this planet. With that, the VL Toys is now part of my Robo Spatium and you can control it through a browser interface, try it out. The capacity of the batteries is good enough for a runtime of no more than 2 hours, which is why this car isn't in operation all day long. However, there are more robots in my Robo Spatium that you can drive for 24 hours a day. An advantage of the 6-wheeler is that it can start outdoor missions. In local mode, the camera can record full high-definition videos and store them on the SD card of the Raspberry Pi. However, to save bandwidth, the resolution is reduced significantly while streaming over internet. I also have written a software that transmits still images in intervals of some seconds because that mode requires no special setup of your network. There are still optimizations to be done, however even in the current hard and software version, the rover can reliably transmit images from far, far away. Thanks for watching and I'll be back!